Walt is the sheriff of the least populated county in the least populated state in America, Wyoming. Wyoming is about half the size of France, but only has about 500,000 people in it, about a half a million people. So there are more buffalo than there are people in Wyoming. But just because there aren't that many people doesn't mean there isn't any crime. And Walt's a little bit different, I think, you know, different kind of a protagonist than the majority of crime fiction. He's more like us, you know. He's overweight, he's overage, he's overly depressed, you know, but he still tries to do the job. And, you know, to me, that's what, you know, makes him an interesting character, the things that we have in common with him. Walt's county, Absaroka County, is actually on the Montana border. So just to the north of Walt's county is the Northern Cheyenne Reservation and the Crow Reservation. These are two very large reservations in Montana, and Walt has a lot of interaction with, you know, both the Crow and the Cheyenne. One of his closest friends, like, as a childhood friend that he grew up with, played, you know, high school football with, and went away to Vietnam and was a soldier with, Henry Standing Bear. And it's interesting because an awful lot of the characters that are in the books tend to be based off of friends of mine. Henry is actually based off of a good friend of mine, Marcus Red Thunder, up on the Northern Cheyenne Reservation, like that. And with the characters, they're constantly in development. They're constantly changing. They're constantly evolving. Simply because I believe that that the lifeblood of a series of books depends on the ability to allow those characters to grow, to allow those characters to evolve. And in this particular book, you know, we discover certain things about Walt. One being that, you know, perhaps he wasn't the best father in the world, like that, in some aspects. He was a good father, like that, but one of the things his daughter says is that, you know, Dad, you know, whenever I graduated from college, you were working on a case. Whenever I graduated from, you know, law school, you were working on a case. And he says, well, there was always a case. And she's like, exactly, there was always a case. And for me, it was interesting to explore the aspects of that storyline that, you know, made it a ticking clock kind of situation where Walt needed to be there for the birth of his first grandchild. And I think it makes for a tight novel. You always try and write something different with each novel. You know, you try and do something different. When you're writing a series of novels, what you don't want to do is become formulaic, you know, where you're doing the same thing over and over and over again. And generally, like that, you're right. In the books, you know, I mean, with the geography, like that, and the space, you know, that the novels usually have, they usually don't unfold at a breakneck kind of speed. But this was a different kind of, you know, of novel. There were three missing women. And as everyone knows, like in these kind of situations, if you don't find those people, if you don't find missing people in a short amount of time, you're probably not going to find them. And so that kind of ratchets up, you know, the pacing of the novel, like that, and ratchets up, you know, the passion, you know, that Walt has to try and find, you know, an answer to this. Then there's also the fact that, like, he does have a limited amount of time. Like, his grandchild is going to be born, and he has to get to Philadelphia for where his daughter's going to have a baby. And she's angry at him about this. And then you've got the rhythmical patterns of the novel itself, in the sense that it's a train book. It's about trains. When you're in that Powder River country, where some of the largest coal mines in the entire world happen, like that, where 80% of the coal power for the United States comes from that one little spot in the Powder River in Wyoming. The coal mines are huge. The trains are 150 cars long. They're a mile and a half long. And so they're going to impose themselves on the storyline, like that it's going to have an effect. And it goes all the way from the beginning. You know, when the novel starts, you know, Walt is sitting on one side of one of those tracks, waiting for one of those 150 car trains to go by. And then, not to give too much away, at the end, he's sitting on one side, waiting for some train cars to go by. So for me, it was actually, it imposed a lot of challenges, but it was also a lot of fun to do something different like that, and to have it, you know, have an effect as far as the pacing was concerned. Humor is tricky. Humor is really a tricky aspect, you know, especially in writing. There are an awful lot of authors that I know that are really funny. You know, they're really, you talk to them and they're just, they're really, really funny, but then you read their books and there's no humor in them at all. And I don't think that I could write a book without humor. I don't think I'm particularly funny, but I like writing funny. I enjoy the humor, you know, that's in the books. And I think that it's kind of, you know, for Walt in many ways, kind of a defense mechanism. It's the way that he deals, you know, with sometimes the very, you know, horrible aspects of the job that he does. He gets to see people at their very best, but he also gets to see people at their very worst. And so in many ways, he's trying to keep his humanity alive, you know, by keeping that sense of humor. But then again, it's also, you know, for me, an important aspect of the book simply because I think it draws the reader in. You know, whenever I'm teaching classes like that, and young authors are asking me, you know, how do you get, you know, readers to empathize with your characters? How do you get them to connect, you know, with your characters? And my immediate response is give them a sense of humor. You know, make them funny like that. And that doesn't mean that you can use the same sense of humor for all the different characters. You know, all of the characters in the books have very specific types of humor that are all their own. The native sense of humor, you know, I'm around a lot of natives. I'm around a lot of the Northern Cheyenne and the Crow. They have a very dry sense of humor. It's a very ironic, you know, sense of humor. Walt is a much more open, warmer type of sense of humor. Vic Moretti, like at his second in charge, the undersheriff, she has a very Eastern, sarcastic, you know, biting, you know, kind of humor like that. And you never know which one is going to work, you know, for the reader. You know, they may respond, you know, to a very sarcastic, you know, style of humor, and they may not find the other types of humor, you know, all that funny. And so it's kind of fun to do that because you can go at them with a couple of different angles, like with a couple of different styles of humor, and see which one will have an effect.